the latest thing.
It's the latest thing, a trash can. Welcome back to Character Slot. That was fucking weird.
Wait.
Do we go to the hobo camp, do you think?
Sure. I don't think the hobo's gonna tell us shit. No, yeah, at least. We need something to... You can't just squeeze King Hobo with nothing.
That's true. Now. He'll put the curse of the mummy on us.
One kind of king.
No, that...
To be fair, it does kind of give you some kind of evil
aura. For the record, that is a weird-ass reference to Dr. McNincha, Archibald King of the Hobos, and...
Oh my god,
and
you're
Sub-Mayor
right.
Mummy. Or whatever his name is.
Fuck me.
Oh boy.
Dr. McNincha was great.
But Dave and Scar back to LA Noir. We're cops. This doesn't count as damage. Bye. Nice.
This song is ass.
Yes. Well, I missed our turn. It's fine.
Imagine going past a cop car and someone screams at it, swerving. I missed our turn. Just fucking shit myself.
It's...
See, Jesus.
It's fine.
You're a fucking menace.
Yes. Clearly. I think the hobo is a red herring, by the way.
Yeah?
It's either a red herring or the guy.
Oh, yeah, good point.
But I'm pretty sure it's a red herring.
Gents, drink. Phelps and Galloway, LAPD. I'm Benny Clough. This is about Teresa Terrellson?
Good guess.
I heard about it on the radio.
Oh, shit.
They're saying it was that Black Dahlia freak again? God damn it. Yeah, I rang that husband of hers. The babysitter said he was out. If you don't mind, we have a few questions.
Boop.
What time did Teresa leave? Around 10:30, I think.
That seems truthful. Okay, I'll believe you.
Sure.
On foot, in a car, by bus, how was it?
She called for a cab.
Did you get the number?
Sure I did. I like Teresa. The only time she has a drink is when things aren't going so good at home. I was worried about it.
Does chicken come with fried tomatoes?
Put
out an APB on the cab. 3591. Should be traceable.
Two rye on ice, one Manhattan, and one gin Ricky? What the hell's a gin Ricky?
I think it's just gin and more alcohol.
Probably.
Like nothing in it. Oh no. Oh, yes. Let's see here. Gin, bourbon, rye whiskey, and lime.
So her husband was half cut.
Highball on side of the water.
So her husband was half cut, but she was three sheets to the wind.
Slashed. She was fucking slashed, yeah.
Fucking hell.
Who was she with? We've had reports about a tall, gaunt-looking hobo. He wasn't here last night? I get plenty of bums in here, but nothing to fit that description.
Oh? But why are you looking away?
Well, then.
Well, fucking, yeah.
Now. All right, so we can't go, lie, I heard hobos exist.
Give it up, Benny. All right, two creeps were all over her, promising to take her dancing. You get a good look at these guys? Sure. I got a good look. One of them was a sailor in uniform. His cap said, USS Indiana. And the other man? The other guy is Richard Bates. He's sitting in the back right now. Red polo shirt.
Okay.
Any idea where she was headed?
Nope. I didn't get that.
That's a doubt. Right? No, he seems to be truthful.
Yeah, sure. Seems fine. True.
The husband said she wanted to go dancing.
And she always wants to dance when she's been drinking. She was trying to talk some guys into taking her to one of the dance halls.
Thank you for your help, Mr. Clough. We'll take it from here.
Hey, no problem.
This is Bates.
Oh, wow. Fucking Cro-Magnon, man.
LAPD, don't make me chase you, shitbird. Can't let the son of a bitch get away.
Goddamn, they love running.
Bates, just want to talk. Come on, gotta ride. Get in and drive.
What?
Thank you, Sap.
I thought you were gonna leave me there.
Ooh, what
this guy will pull when he's cornered. We could have a killer on our hands.
Hope you're insured. Not my fault.
Let's end this part.
All right, you got me. Give it up,
LAPD.
I don't think he was supposed to crash that, but you know,
I'll take
whatever.
Okay, Bates.
Yeah, free win.
You're gonna answer some questions. I have a choice in this.
No.
God, man, he doesn't have so much of an overbite as an overfeast.
Now she's dead, and your face is all messed up. I'm in the clear on that. She preferred a sailor. You could lay it off on him. Are we finished?
Doubt.
Think so?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Do you want my partner to sap you?
Jesus!
Tell us what we want to know. She was okay. Drunk. Pissed off at her old man, wanting to go dancing. I thought I'd ply her with a few drinks and get my end away. Looks like your salty had the same idea.
So what happened when you left the bar?
Sailor boy laid one on me. A cheap shot. After that, I don't know.
Doubt.
Oh my god, look at him internally flex his doubts.
I'm so doubt worthy.
Is that why you ran?
I'm on parole.
On what offense?
Sexual assault.
No kidding.
Look, ooh. I was lying there on the sidewalk. He flags a cab and jumps in with the broad.
We're taking you in, Bates.
How come?
Just for a chat. Nice private chat.
Also,
I'll explain my theory.
Traffic accident.
Always a degenerate.
Yeah, he did also, yeah, cut, run, and ram into it. Weird. In a cozy
cell. Richard here knows the drill.
Dick, of course, Dick knows the drill. Swish.
Hey, and our car's perfectly fine because we weren't driving it.
Yeah, sorry about that. Really, quite pretty Ford.
All right, so there's a. What the fuck?
The lamppost. Oh, wow. Okay.
That wasn't me.
It just remembered it got hit like a... Wait, oh, I know what happened. The car is supposed to crash into that lamppost, but we got him early. Since it's teleported us.
I thought somebody hit somebody else. Just like, what the fuck?
No, it just... That lamppost was like, oh yeah, I'm supposed to be knocked over.
I get an APB out on a yellow cab, number 3591. Ask dispatch to relay all sightings to car 11K.
No problem. I'll get on the radio.
Were there any incident reports filed in the vicinity of Baron's Bar on North Beaudry Avenue? We're tracking a sailor who was involved in a fight outside the bar.
I can check the reports, detective. I have a message for you from Captain Donnelly. Message reads, James Jessup, U.S. Navy able seaman, has information relevant to your case.
Really?
Jessup is currently being detained at Central Station.
Wow, that's convenient.
Thanks for your help.
James Jessup.
Should
we go shake down James?
Not the cop who solved the big case and got promoted.
Several times, in fact.
We have to wait on the cab, I assume.
Well, we could only...
Do you want to try out this hobo cab?
Yeah, let's go to the hobo cab.
We're going to get fisted by hobos, aren't we?
Oh, never mind.
Regarding yellow cab number 3591, the vehicle has been identified at a gas station. Now heading west on 7th Street.
Get moving.
Oof. We ought to investigate the hobo lead.
Well, if you think we ought to, I guess we ought.
Actually,
I have a sneaking suspicion this was a bad idea.
I hope you're right.
Yeah.
This seems more important.
Yeah.
Conspicuousness is for cops, and that's what we are. Sirens all the way.
11K, yellow cab number 3591, sighted at the corner of Wilshire and Whitford. Repeat, Wilshire and Whitmer, 11K.
Thank you. Wrong direction.
These poor bastards are not safe with you on the road.
I did no damage in our last case, thank you.
It's true, but it bothers me that I think of that as sheer luck more than anything.
I mean, honestly, I probably caused a shit ton of medical bills. Oh, that was him. That was him.
That just went past you. Just like turn away. He's like, oh, I guess I'm fine. Go on then.
LAPD.
I'm surprised, actually. I was confused for a moment that you weren't having to chase him.
What was the woman wearing?
It was a green dress. Oh, don't tell me something's happened to her.
Tell me about her.
She was with this sailor. He was all over. She wasn't having any of it. Said she just wanted to dance. But he had that look in his eye.
Where did you drop them off?
It's at the Crystal Ballroom.
What time?
After midnight. 12:30? Something like that.
Thanks. You've been a big help.
All right.
That's gonna ruin my day.
Good. Who gives a shit about your day?
I mean, I guess I'm bothered knowing that you, like, saw someone who's like, oh, God, and she was with this really handsy guy. And now she's dead, and you didn't do anything. In fact, you probably delivered her to her last destination. I'd be bothered, too.
So I think...
All right, yeah, I guess.
I think we should go to the hobo camp specifically, not because I think the guy's a suspect, but because I think he might give us evidence or might have seen something. That's my guess.
Yeah.
Oh, the car is slippery. Oh, God. Oh, God. Yeah, we're fine. It's fine. It's fine. In 1 month alone, over 200 were killed, and their hides sold. It takes a nice... Oh, shit. Look out. Okay, we're good.
But, oh, wow. Okay, so on this guide, they did Baron's Bar, and then immediately went to the central police station, and just glancing past the interrogation I see, when you leave the police station, a short cutscene gives you the location of the hobo camp. Don't go there yet. I'm like, oh, we have fucked our order. Let's just commit. We're gonna get weird clues out of order, aren't we?
Hey, he hit me. Alright. So, what, you think we should, do you think we should go back to central then?
I feel like it's probably too late. I don't know.
Nah, we can do it.
What bothers me is it's only like halfway through all the places.
Really?
Oh. Yeah. I don't want to look too closely.
Well, we've got James Jessup to interrogate. As well as, Clough, Richard Clough. Or not Richard, not Clough. Whatever the hell his name is,
Clem.
I don't know. Clem. No. Clem was the guy in the last case.
That was that last guy. I don't fucking know. Captain Overbite.
Captain Overbite. Baron Underbite.
Oh, Richard Bates, that was it. Dick Bates.
Dick Bates. Yeah, that's such a great name. All right.
He's an interview too.
Thanks.
What do you make of him? Sailor on furlough, who looks like he's in trouble and knows it.
Detectives Phelps and Galloway.
So Abel Seaman is essentially a private first class, by the way.
I don't want any.
I just thought you had really Abel Seaman.
I heard on the radio about this lady getting killed. I got leave from my CO to come down straight away.
So why did you kill her?
I didn't kill anyone. Look, you need to believe me.
Let's start at the beginning. You went to Baron's Bar. What time did you arrive?
I got a 24-hour pass. I got there around 7.
That's where you met Teresa Terrelson?
Sure. We had a couple of drinks.
Doubt.
So you tried to make a woman who was incredibly drunk?
Look, I'm not proud of myself, but I never hurt her.
You took her dancing?
That's right. Caught a cab to the Crystal Ballroom.
Okay, that matches.
Yeah.
You had a fist fight with Richard Bates over Mrs. Taraldson.
You met the guy? He's a creep. You should take a look at him for this.
Doubt.
He didn't mention that fist fight, did he?
He's pointing a finger directly at you, Jessup.
I only had one night before I was back in the tub. He had all the time in the world to look for some action. I belted him. I'd do it again. She was better off with me.
Sure. You're a shining example of chivalry, Jessup. Where did you go after the Crystal Ballroom?
I think the wind had gone out of her sails by then. She caught a cab, and I caught a bus back to the base.
Doubt!
Man, he is dishing us straight doubts.
We spoke to the cab driver. Tell us what really happened at the Crystal Ballroom.
I'd had enough. She was all upset about her husband bawling about her kids. She looked old. Left around closing, maybe 1:30. We got on a bus and she fell asleep on my shoulder.
Which bus?
An All-American, 249. I went past her place. She jumped off and I stayed on it downtown. After that, I caught another bus to San Pedro. The Indiana's down there. She's being scrapped.
And that was the last you saw of Teresa?
Yeah, that's right. We didn't say much. I think she was kind of embarrassed.
The cab driver said that you were getting pretty familiar with Teresa.
Go on, I can't wait for you to dish us on a doubt.
That's not how I'd put it. So how... No, I think it's truth.
No, that's doubt.
You think so?
Yeah, we're supposed to make him say shit.
Yeah, it's the last one anyway.
Alright. This one was cab ride with the victim?
Doubt. Yeah, okay.
So the last thing you wanted was her playing hard to get. Did that make you mad, Sailor?
Yeah, it did. She knew what a guy's looking for, all broads do. Dancing comes second.
And what depends on the kind of dancing, doesn't it?
Nothing. Not even a little hand relief. She had another couple of drinks. There was no fun left in her. Just poured her guts out to some bartender.
We're holding you till we can clear this with the driver.
Yeah, my CO said as much.
Can you put the guy in two in a cell and inform the commander?
Sure, detective.
I don't like him for it, though.
Got a message for you.
Nah.
Sighting of your disfigured hobo on Grand between Temple and Sunset. And it looks like the beau has a record, too. He's wanted in connection with two female assaults.
Thanks.
I don't think I like the husband for it either, even though he's not being straight.
Let's see if the bus story checks out.
There's a depot at 1660 Beverly Boulevard.
Huh. All right. Next time on Character Select, we're going after a bus? Sure?
Bus, I guess. Although, weirdly enough, they actually did give us the address for the Hobocam last time. But I've literally read where it's like, don't go there yet, and it gives you the address. So, yeah. My bad. I just... Straight up cheating, I guess.
11K, go ahead.
Patrolman reporting that Bobby Ross's car key was breaking up at midnight.
Really?
11K, roger that. Only have time to get downtown, bro.
It's possible. Have them bring him in.
KTPL, we have Lars Taraldson picked up.
7K, roger.
Interesting. Okay. So thank you very much for watching. Make sure to click that like button down below if you liked it. And... Scout.
Don't do murders.
I mean, that's good advice no matter.
Yeah,
it's good advice no matter where you are. Really? Unless it's your job, in which case, do murders well.
Yeah, do murders correctly.
Some weird advice to be giving.
Yeah, do murders legally. That's our advice today.